Maxine Ashford.
Hello.
Where are you a franchisee from?
Barrie, Ontario.
Barrie, Ontario. And I was talking to Charles, and he said you guys were sitting on the beach in Jamaica for his 50th birthday.
That's right.
Discussing, what were you discussing?
The 10 things that we'd like to do in the next 10, 20 years.
And they were?
Well, the number one on the list was save a life.
Save a life. And at this time, you had no idea that anybody that you knew would require any sort of assistance from you whatsoever, right?
No, we were just thinking of maybe building a house over in a different country and just helping out that way. That's our version of helping, saving a life.
How long was it before you got the Facebook posting?
I think it was like not even a week. Like, I think we got back on a Monday, and I think it was Wednesday or Thursday of the same week that we got the Facebook.
You got a Facebook posting from Lana down in Minnesota, and Lana and Troy are franchisees of Lemon Heaven down in Minnesota.
She posts that she needs people to be tested to be a match, a donor for a kidney. She had PKD disease.
So how long has she been looking for a transplant?
She's been looking for a long time. Just recently it got down to where she was probably going to have to go on dialysis by January of this year. So she would have, her counts were all getting lower and lower. So
it's getting kind of desperate.
Yes.
Yeah. So both you and Charles tested?
We did. He tested first. Yeah. And he was a match. His counts came in, I'm not quite sure what the numbers were, but mine came in much better than his. And she had another friend who came in, but I was the better match.
Yeah. So you were way better than Charles, is what you're saying.
Way better than Charles.
Good. So how did it evolve from there? What happened? I mean,
just went to get blood tests done, and then they, the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, is where it all happened. And they send up all the boxes of everything that you have to get tested, and you send it all down. They and then they just said that I had to go down to get more tests done. So I went down in June for 3 days of testing, and it was an experience. It was fun. We three of us hung out together, Lana, Charles, and I, and had to have 24-hour urine, and Charles had to hold the bottle.
Yeah.
Carry it around everywhere that we went for 24 hours.
At all of our conventions, of course, we have an after party. And this after party was an amazing race to Tofino, British Columbia from Vancouver. So it involved ferry rides and certain obstacles along the way. And one of the obstacles was an adventure park in Nanaimo, where the challenge was either bungee jumping or the cane swing or the Monkito course. First of all, teams had to separate from their spouses, which I think really brought people together. Do you agree?
Oh yes, it was fun. It was absolutely one of the best times of my life. Yes.
So who was on your team?
Lana and Rob from Winnipeg and Wayne from Victoria. Well, we're not quite to the adventure park yet. We're driving, and Charles and Troy and Greg was on the other team. And they were mocking us from the other car driving down the highway that they knew where we were going, and there was no way what we would do it. They were booing us and taunting us, and Lana and I just looked at each other and gave a high five and said, let's do it. So we...
And had either of you done anything like that before?
Never. I'm scared of heights. So we get to the park, we run up to the counter, we pay. And then we come around the corner, and Charles and Troy had just gotten there because we'd beaten them. And they're like, what are you doing? And we're like, we're going on the king swing. And they're like, oh man. So yeah, and then all I remember is Miriam, I'm looking over at Miriam, and I'm like, well, where do we go now? And she's like, up there. And I'm like, oh gosh.
So you'd committed before you knew what you were getting into.
Oh, yeah.
Probably a good thing.
Oh yeah, probably a good thing.
So you guys get up to the top, and what were you thinking at the time?
Before we get to the top, we had to go up these stairs, and the stairs were all open, and the bridge was like kind of over the canyon, I call it. So we go up the stairs and I get three stairs and I'm like hot and sweaty and I can't go up, I can't go up. And Lana goes, let's just look up. And she hooked on my arm and she goes, we're going up, 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 up. And off we go to the top. And then I get to the top and I'm like, what have I got myself into? But yeah.
So you get to the top, you get all strapped in, you're sitting on the edge. And what are you thinking? Looking down. Well,
Lana was asking a million questions. Like, I didn't get a word in edgewise. She had the poor guy, like, just answering everything. And when he swung the gate open and our feet went down, I was like, oh my God. And Lana still didn't stop talking. So I think she was a good influence, you know.
Calming influence?
Calming influence, I guess, yeah.
So the guy says, oh, it's just the first, it's only 6 feet.
6 feet, yep. It's only 6 feet. Yeah, it was 60.
So he forgot to add a zero.
He forgot to add the zero, which Lana pointed out to him when we got down there.
So the rest of the trip was pretty good bonding. I mean, we all sat in the hot tub and in the condos on the wet and wild BC coast, out on the open ocean, and with the waves crashing in and the rain pouring down, and we all had a little bit of a bonding experience.
Well, I didn't realize we had such great music talent. We had Nate playing the guitar and Troy playing the bongos, and you have a singing voice.
Oh,
who knew?
Nobody at that. Nobody at that party. So you get back, you go to Jamaica, you want to save a life, you get back, and all of a sudden you see Lana's post on Facebook. So now you're down and you've got the testing kits, you're way better than Charles at matching kidneys, and you head on down to the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. And what happened after that? I mean, did you find out immediately when you were down there?
At the third day, we got all the results for all the tests.
And by this time, you're back at home?
Nope, we're still there. Okay. At the end of the day, on the third day, I think it was a Thursday. And it's so cool down there. You know, they throw my body up on a computer and they take out the heart and everything, and they just left the kidneys. It was like, it was amazing. And they printed it off for me and they said, so we're gonna take the right kidney. This is gonna be Lana's kidney. And so I come out of the last meeting and I'm like, this is yours, you know, and she's crying. And it was just really, really emotional. Yeah.
So you head back to Toronto after that, right?
We head back June something, and then went through both summers because we both own lemonade stands. We always say that, you know, summer is lemonade season, so that's our busiest season.
So you can't do a kidney transplant during lemon heaven season. So you got to postpone the kidney transplant until the season's over.
I know, I was feeling really bad about that, but Lana's like, no, I have so much to do too, so I feel okay.
So you you get back and you go through your lemon heaven season.
Yes.
And the next time you were down in Minnesota was for an operation?
It was. It was crazy. We finished our event Monday night of Thanksgiving, and Krista and I drove home. It was 3.5 hours. I get my bags and everything. She drives me to the airport. I fly out the very next day. And then that day, and then the next day, I had Wednesday, I had all the tests, more tests, blood tests, just normal stuff. And then Charles flew down that day, and then the surgery was on Thursday, so it was kind of crazy.
Speaking of Charles and Krista and the rest of your family back in Newfoundland, how did they feel about you going through this?
They were pretty proud. My parents are pretty cool. My dad only has one kidney, so he knew that, you know, you can live off one kidney. So they were really, really supportive. My whole family was really, really supportive. And my friends, so it was great. October 11th was the surgery.
Yeah.
And that was pretty cool. We both went in the hospital like the morning of, and all of her family were there, so that was really nice. And then you go into surgery and they basically line you up in the surgery, and everybody in the surgery this day was having the first of anything, so that was kind of cool. And then we noticed on the wall in front of us was 10, 11, 12, that was the date.
Oh, really?
So,
that's kind of cool.
That's
kind of
cool. Yeah, so.
And Lon and Troy have a few boys?
They have two boys.
Two boys?
Adam, it was his birthday that day, October 11th.
Wow.
Yeah, and Alex is 19, and Adam is 24. for.
So since the surgery, I mean, you must have talked to them quite often. And
every day. Oh, every day. She sends me thank you cards. Like, I have piles of them. Christmas gifts. And we just had another Lemon Heaven conference last week. They came.
Yeah.
And of course, I got more presents and cards.
Yeah.
And
yeah. Charles told me it got to the point where you had to tell them to stop.
Stop.
Saying thank you and sending gifts, otherwise you were going to have to ask for the kidney back.
Yeah, she's just so thankful and grateful, and she calls me her angel on earth.
Now you guys have a bond for life.
Absolutely. And going in, I said, it was funny, when we were holding hands, I said, no, we're going in as friends, we have to come out as friends. So that was our commitment to each other, stay friends. So she keeps saying that she's part Canadian.
Yeah, that's for sure.
So it was kind of funny. The day after surgery, I was so sick. Like, just when you go into surgery, right? I was just so sick. And she was up running around, like she was eating chocolate cake, and just, you know, boot scooting down the hallway, and I'm still lying in bed. I'm like, okay, what's up with that?
So the I didn't ask you about the surgery itself. Like, was it when you was, I mean, obviously they just put you out, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's, how long does the surgery take? I mean, is it a,
I think, I mean, it was, is like it, two and a half hours, I think it was, tell you the truth. I can't even remember. I remember coming to, and there's, Charles has a picture of that too, with me just sitting there like.
Yeah. So you basically, you go in, they put the mask on you, you fall asleep, you come out and.
Yeah, there was no mask. They just put the intravenous in you.
Oh, the drip in you?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then, like, all I remember is going from one bed to the bed, and they were saying count to, I think I got to seven, and that's it.
You were out. And when you woke up, was it a painful recovery, or how long did the recovery take?
The surgery was on Thursday. I was out of the hospital on Sunday. And then Rob and Sandy from Winnipeg came down and kind of gave me a boost of energy. And then Monday, we were at Walmart. Yep. Rob was pushing me around in a Walmart wheelchair. And then Tuesday we flew home.
Yeah.
And then Friday I was at the airport picking my parents up. And then by Sunday we're in Windsor. And then, so recovery was pretty quick.
And Lana, I mean, obviously her recovery is a little bit longer. And more complex, but.
She went back to work on Monday. She's a lunch lady at one of the schools. So she's doing really well.
Yeah, now she has to go back for one more surgery, is it? Or a couple more surgeries?
I think they're going for October, because it's gonna be after lemonade season.
Right? Yeah.
And they're gonna remove her old two kidneys.
Yeah, so far she's making a remarkable recovery. I believe she was ahead of schedule.
Oh yes, she's, both of us are way ahead of schedule.
So that must have been an amazing kidney that you gave her.
I know.
Well, everybody at Lemon Heaven, and I'm sure all your friends and family, really, really admire you for what you've done. And you're a great example of a wonderful human being, and we all wish we could be like you.